Hi guys, welcome to all. This is Srinivas Zarani and today's topic is pipes and cisterns. So this topic pipes and cisterns is very much similar to the topic of time and work. So if you people are thorough with the concepts of the time and work and if you have already solved the problems of time and work, so you can easily solve this pipes and cistern. So mostly might be 2 to 3 questions will appear in your examinations like SSC, CGL or it may be banks, PVOs or IBPS. So whatever the examination may be, you will get at least 2 or 3 questions and these questions are very simple in nature, so you can easily solve if you have a thorough in the concept. So there is a small concept behind this topic, so based on that small concept we are going to solve various models. So I have collected some numerous models so that which have been appeared in the previous examination and which are very, very important. So let's see. So the small concept is, in these pipes and cisterns, the concept here lies is there is a tank and there is a tap. So this tap X, sorry, let's consider this tap to be A. The tap A takes X hours to fill this tank. Here what we consider is the total volume of the tank, we consider it to be 1 unit. So a tap A takes X hours to complete, sorry, to fill the 1 unit. I mean, in 1 hour, how many units it can fill? So if you interchange, it is equal to in 1 hour, it fills 1 by Xth part. So keep remember this small concept. Based on this small concept, entire problems will be solved. So tank, a tap. So it takes X hours to fill the tank. So we are considering the volume of the tank to be 1 unit. So it takes X hours to finish the work of 1 unit and 1 hour it fills the 1 by X part of the tank. Now let's move into the question. The very first question is, there are two pipes A and B. Can fill a tank in 36 hours and 45 hours respectively. If both the pipes are open simultaneously, how much time will be taken to fill the tank? The question is very simple. There is a tank and there are two taps. This is tap A and tap B. So when tap A is just on, I mean if single tap A is on, it takes 36 hours to fill the tank. When tank B is on, it takes 45 hours to fill the tank. Now let's solve the problem by using conventional method and we can also solve the problem by using the LCM method which we have applied already in the time and work. So how do we solve? If a tank A takes 36 hours to fill the tank, that means in 1 hour 1 by 36th part will be filled, isn't it? The concept lies here is we are considered to be the total volume as 1 unit. So the 1 unit of the work will be done in 36 hours. So in 1 hour 1 by 36th part will be filled by tap A and tap B takes 45 hours to fill the tank. In 1 hour this tap B fills 1 by 45th part, isn't it? Now A and B, he has asked that when taps A and B are on simultaneously, then how many hours it will take to fill the tank. So if A and B are on in 1 hour, how much part of the tank will be filled? That is 1 by 36 plus 1 by 45, that is equal to 9 by 180, that is equal to 1 by 20th part. That means if A and B taps are on for 1 hour, in 1 hour they fill 1 by 20th part. So in 1 hour they fill 1 by 20th part. So in to fill 1 unit, how much amount of the time it will take? That is equal to, in 1 hour it take 1 by 20th part. So in how many hours to fill entire 1 unit? So if you interchange, that is equal to, it takes 20 hours. So when A and B are on simultaneously, it takes 20 hours. So this concept is very much and very much similar to the topic of time and work. See, if there is a person A who can do the work in 36 days and the person B who can do the work in 45 days, now what we have considered, A plus B combinedly together do the work in how many days? So this is the same question, but the concept, that means the terminology is different. Here we have taken it as tank, filling of tank. So rest of the thing is same, the solving of the problem is same, the concept is same. Now this is a convention method. Let's move to the LCM method, that which we have used in the time and work. What is the LCM method we have applied in time and work? There is a tap A, B, it takes 36 hours, it takes 45 hours. Now we are taking LCM of both these two, that is 48. So we take it to be liters. So total 180 liters. So tap A 36 and 180 liters per hour. Tap A fills how many liters? That means that is equal to 36 by 8. So 920 is a 94 is a, so 5 liters per hour. So tap A fills 5 liters per hour and again tap B 95 is a and 920 is a, so it fills 4 liters per hour. So in an hour, A tap fills 5 liters, B tap fills 4 liters. So A plus B in 1 hour, how many liters of the water they will fill? 5 plus 4, that is equal to 9 liters per hour, A plus B. So how many total? 180 liters. That means in 1 hour it fills 9 liters. So in how many hours it fills 180 liters? That is equal to 180 by 9. So 20 hours. So this is the LCM method. So you just take the LCM of these two numbers. In a hour, per hour, how many liters of the water will be filled by tap A and how many liters of the water will be filled by tap B? In 1 hour, you add, then you get how many liters of the water filled by A and B in 1 hour, that is 9 liters. In 1 hour, if A and B taps are on simultaneously, they fill 9 liters. Now, in how many hours, the 180 liters will be filled. So that is equal to 180 by 9, 20 hours. So this is this problem we are solved, we have already been solved in time and work. So the concept here is same. So the models will be different. So let's move to the next question. The second question is, two pipes can fill a tank in 15 hours and 20 hours respectively, while the third pipe empty the tank in 30 hours. If all the pipes are opened at a time, the empty tank fill in how many hours? So the question is again very much simple. There is a pipe. So this is a pipe A, this is pipe B, and there is another pipe B. So here it fills and here it empties. So A pipe fills the tank in 15 hours, B pipe fills the tank in 20 hours, and the pipe C, it empties the tap in 30 hours. So to fill the tank, it takes how many hours? So that means our question. A tap can fill the tank in 15 hours when it is on, and B tap can fill the tank in 20 hours, and C tap can empty the tank in 30 hours. But when all these three taps are on simultaneously, how much time will it take to fill the tank? So the convention method here is A takes 15 hours. So in 1 hour, how much part of the work will be done by A? That means how much part will be filled by A? That is 1 by 15th part. Similarly, B takes 20 hours. That means in 1 hour, so it fills 1/20th part of the tank. Similarly, C, here the tap A and B fills, but the tap C empties the tank. So it takes 30 hours to empty. Remind this. It is emptying and these two taps A and B are filling. That means in 1 hour, it can empty 1/30th part. So it's when these are simultaneously on, that means A plus B, but here we take it as C. Why? Because this is emptying the tank. So we are not adding C, we are minus subtracting the C. Why? Because this tap C is emptying the tank. So that is equal to 1/15 plus 1/20 minus 1/13. At LCM is 60. So 4 plus 3 minus 2, that is equal to 1 by 12. So when A and B and C are on, in 1 hour they fill 1/12th part. So in 1 hour they fill 1/20th part. In how many hours they fill total tank? That is equal to 12 hours. So how did you get? I hope you understand. In 1 hour, all the three can fill 12th part. So in how many hours they fill total 1 unit? So if you cross multiply, you get 12 answer. Or directly simply you can take the numerator to the above and denominator, you get the answer. So this is the conventional method. This problem is also very much similar to the problem of time and work, but the difference is here we are subtracting C, there we are adding it. Here if you take the person A can do the work in 15 days, 20 days and 30 days. So here the negativity comes. So that's the difference between the concept of pipes and systems and the time and work. Rest remains the same. So again, this problem can be solved in LCM method also, like taking the LCM of all the three, the LCM would be, so let's solve it. The LCM method, what would be the LCM? If A takes 15, B 20 and C 30. So the LCM is 60. In 1 hour it takes 4 liters, it fills 4 liters. Here it fills 3 liters and here in 1 hour it fills 2 liters. So in 1 hour. Now in 1 hour, A plus B minus C, that is equal to 4 plus 3 minus 2, that is equal to 5 liters per hour. So when all the three taps are on, 5 liters of the water will be filled. So in 1 hour, if 5 liters of the water are filled, in how many hours 60 liters of the water will be filled? So if you cross multiply, you get 60/5, that is equal to 12 hours. So this is the LCM method and this is the conventional method. Whatever the method you would like to do, but the concept remains the same. So let me move to the third question. So a tank can be filled by a pipe A in 2 hours and the pipe B in 6 hours. At 10 am if pipe A was open, at what time will be the tank will be filled if pipe B is opened at 11 am? So the question is very simple. A tank, again a pipe A, pipe B. Here if this pipe A is on, that means it takes 2 hours to fill the tank and the B takes 6 hours to fill the tank. When tap A is on, it takes 2 hours to fill the tank. When tap B is on, it takes 6 hours to fill the tank. But when the both are on, how much time it will take? But the question is little bit different. The question here asked is, if at 10 a.m. if pipe A was opened. So this pipe A was opened at 10 a.m. and at what time the dam will be filled if, and this was opened at 11 a.m. Here the difference is, these pipes are not on simultaneously. The first A pipe is on and it is on for 1 hour, and after 1 hour B pipe is on. So let's see how the problem is solved. So if A takes 2 hours to fill the tank, in 1 hour it fills 1/2 the part of the tank, and B takes 6 hours to fill the tank, in 1 hour how much amount the part of the tank will be filled? That is 1/6 part of the tank will be filled. But A is on at 10 a.m. B is on at 11 a.m. Both are not on simultaneously, not on at a time. Then how much amount of the time will be taken? So if A is gonna work for 1 hour, I mean 10 to 11, after 11 o'clock B will be on. So A alone can fill half of the tank in just 1 hour, from 10 a.m. to 11 a.m. That means from 10 to 11 a.m. A alone fills half the tank, isn't it? So in 1 hour it fills 1/2, that means half the tank. After 11 a.m. B also start working. So after 11 a.m. now A plus B fills the tank. How much of the tank is empty now? So the remaining space is 1 minus 1/2. Already the half of the tank is filled by A, so the remaining is 1/2. So A and B has to fill 1/2. That means, so in 1 hour A plus B, how much amount of the tank they will fill? 1/2 plus 1/6, that is equal to, so 3 plus 1/6, that is equal to 4/6, so 2/3. So in 1 hour A and B can fill 2/3 part, but what we need, we need only half. That means 2/2 part will be filled in 1 hour, but to fill half, one half, how many hours it will take? If you interchange, that is equal to 3/4 hours, that is equal to 45 minutes. So the total time taken to fill the tank is, the tap A is on at 10 a.m. and it continued to 11 a.m. and after 11 a.m. both A and B are started. So 1 hour, that means the time taken here is 10 a.m. to 11 a.m. Here the tap A is worked from 11 a.m. to 11:45 a.m. both A and B are worked. So the time taken is 1 hour 45 minutes. I hope you got the clarity. The question is very simple. There are two tank and two taps. Tap A can fill the tank in 2 hours, tap B in 6 hours. So they are not on simultaneously. In the previous problem we had considered that all the taps are on simultaneously. That means at one point there is a starting point which is same to both the taps, but here the starting point is different. Here it is on 1 hour earlier. So in 1 hour that the amount of the tank that is filled by tap A is half. So half of the tank is already filled by tap A. The remaining half should be filled by both A and B, where both A and B can fill 2/3 in 1 hour. So in half of the tank can be filled in 45 minutes. So total work is 1 hour 45 minutes. I hope you got the clarity. Now let's move to the other question. So the next question is, if a pump can fill a tank with water in 2 hours, because of a leak in the tank, it was taking 2 1/3 hours to fill the tank. The leak can drain all the water of the tank in how many hours? So the question is, again there is a tank and there is a pipe A. So it takes 2 hours to fill the tank, but there is a small leakage. So due to that leakage, so it gonna take 2 1/3 hours to fill the tank. How you wanna solve the problem? So the question is again very simple. Here let's consider this leak as the second pipe. So then you are going to get the solution. So this leak we consider it to be pipe B. So pipe A takes 2 hours to fill the tank. That means in 1 hour it fills half the tank. Similarly, because of the leak, so it takes 2.5 hours. That means A minus B, so combined it takes 2 1/3, that is equal to 7/3 hours. So in 1 hour, how much amount of the water will be filled by this 3/7 of the tank? Now what we want, we just want the B. So how much amount of the time will be taken by the B to empty the tank? So the question is very simple. So in 1 hour it takes half, so A plus B combined, that means A and B combined, it takes 3/7 of the tank. Now so A can do half of the tank minus B, that which we want to find. Now both combined can fill 3/7, so B is equal to 1/2 minus 3/7, that is equal to LCM is 14, so 7 minus 6, 1/14. So in 1 hour B fills 1/14 part. So in how many hours B will, sorry, in 1 hour B empties 1/14th part. That means in 1 hour B empties 1/14th part. So in how many hours total 1 unit of the tank will be emptied? That is equal to, if you cross multiply, 14 hours. So he is given some confused, but you should not confuse. You can convert the question. That is, he has said that the tank can be filled in 2 hours by a tap A, but because of the leakage, so time taken to fill the tank is 2 1/3. So extra 1/3 time is taken. Now let's consider this leakage as tap B, which is emptying the tank. So here comes the negativity. A takes, that means 2 hours. A minus B takes 7/3 hours. So in 1 hour A can fill half of the tank. In 1 hour A minus B fill 7/30th tank. So A and A minus B, that gives you, so ultimately you get the value of the B that empties the tank in 1 hour. So if 1 hour it empties 1/14th part, so in how many hours it empties complete unit? So you get 14 hours. Now let's move to other question. Here this question is quite interesting. There are two pipes A and B fill a tank in 30 minutes and 15 minutes respectively, and there is a pipe C which drains 12 liters of water per minute. If all of them are kept open when the tank is full, then the tank empties in 30 minutes. So how much water can the tank hold? Here he has said that again there is a tank, there are two pipes this pipe is A, the other pipe is B, and there is another pipe which is C. So the pipe A takes how many hours? Sorry, 30 minutes to fill this tank, and whereas pipe B takes 15 minutes to fill the tank. But he hasn't given the the amount of time that taken to drain, but he said that C can drain 12 liters of water per minute. So in a minute, 12 liters of the water can be drained by tap C. Now let's find, and the question he has asked is, already the tank is filled. So the tank is already filled. Now if you on the tap simultaneously, that means tap A, tap B and tap C with the filling of the tank. So when in the full tank, when you on the tank, so it takes 30 minutes to drain the complete tank. So the now time take, now how much amount of the volume that the tank holds? This was our question. So let's take total volume of the tank is equal to V. That means total volume of the tank is V liters. Now A can fill the tank in 30 minutes. That means how many liters A fills the tank in 1 minute? So A takes 30 minutes to fill total V liters. So in 1 minute, A takes V by 30 liters. That means A fills V by 30 liters in 1 minute, isn't it? Similarly, tap B takes 15 minutes to fill total volume of V liters. So in 1 minute, it takes V by 15 liters. So that means A can fill the tank in 30 liters. That means a V liter, that means V liters of the tank can be filled in 30 minutes. So in 1 minute, that means V by 30 liters can be filled. So in similarly in B, V by 15 liters can be filled in 1 minute. Now the question he has given that the already the tank is full. So how much amount of the water will be present in the tank? So the tank takes 30 minutes to drain completely if C tap is running. That means tap C drains 12 liters per minute. So in a minute it drains 12 liters and it works for 30 liters. So this much amount of the water will be continuously flowing out in 30 minutes. So this is equal to, already the tank is full, so the volume of the tank is V. Now so how much amount of the volume is present in 1 minute? That means V by 30 plus V by 15. So in 1 minute V liters, that means V by 30 liters, in 1 minute V by 15 liters by B. So they work for 30 minutes. So I hope you got clarity. So it's a bit confusing question, get clarity. So he said that the tank is already full. So C drains 12 liters per minute and it works for 30 minutes. So this much amount of the water will be drained for 30 minutes. So the amount of the water which is drained is equal to V already, which is present V, and the tap A takes V by 30 liters to fill in 1 minute and V by 15 liters in 1 minute, and these two taps runs for 30 minutes. So this is equal to this. Now from this you get V plus, so the LCM is 30, 3V by 30 into, so 12 into 30 is equal to 4V. So V is equal to 90 liters. So the capacity of the tank is 90 liters. So I hope you got clarity. Now let's move to the other question. three pipes A, B, C can fill a tank from empty to full in 30 minutes, 20 minutes and 10 minutes respectively. When the tank is empty, all the three pipes are open. So A, B, C discharges a chemical solution P, Q and R respectively. What is the proportion of the solution R in the liquid in the tank after 3 minutes?
So again, there is a tank, tap A, here is tap B and here is another tap C. So tap A, B, let's consider it as C. So this tap
A takes
30 minutes
and tap B takes
20 minutes and tap C takes 10 minutes to fill the tank, and at the same time this releases a chemical of P and it releases a chemical of Q and it releases a chemical of R. So when the three tanks, that means,
so tap A, tap B, tap C, the time taken to fill the tanks are 30 minutes, 20 minutes and 10 minutes. So tap A releases a chemical P and tap B releases a chemical Q and tap C releases chemical R. So what is the proportion of the chemical R that is present in the tank, that means total liquid after 3 minutes. So that we need to find out. So in 30 minutes it can fill. So A takes 30 minutes to fill the tank. Now in 1 minute, how much amount of the tank will be filled? 1 by 30th part. Similarly, B takes 20 minutes to fill the tank. In 1 minute, it takes 1 by, it fills 1 by 20th. So similarly, C, it takes 10 minutes to fill the tank. In 1 minute, it fills 1 by 10th part of the tank. And A releases a chemical P, B releases chemical Q and C releases a chemical R. Now these three taps are on for 3 minutes. So these are 1 minute. So in 1 minute A plus B plus C, how much part of the tank will be filled? 1 by 30 plus 1 by 20 plus 1 by 10, that is equal to, the LCM would be 60, isn't it? So 2 plus 3 plus 6, so 9, 11 by 60th. So when A and B and C are on at a time, so 11 by 60th part of the tank will be filled in 1 minute. So these taps are open for 3 minutes. In 3 minutes, they fill 3 into 11 by 60, so that is equal to 20. So 11 by 20th part of the tank will be filled by both A, B, C and in 3 minutes. Now he has asked the ratio of solution R, that means chemical R released in this total amount. So how much amount of the chemical is released by C in 1 minute? That is 1 by 10th. So in 3 minutes, into 3. So in 3 minutes, 3 by 10th of the chemical is, that means chemical R is being released into the liquid. So now the ratio, that means proportion, R in liquid is 3 by 10 divided by 11 by 20, that is equal to 3 by 10 into 20 by, so 6 by 11 is the ratio. So the proportion of the R in the liquid after 3 minutes is 6 by 11. So this is our answer. Sorry, don't get confused. 6 divided by 11. So I hope you got clarity. So there is a tank, tap A, B, C, 30 minutes takes, it takes 20 minutes and it takes 10 minutes. So it also releases chemical P, Q and R respectively. So in 1 minute it fills 1 by 30th part, and similarly B fills 1 by 20th part, and the sea fills 1 by 10th part. So if they simultaneously earn, so in 1 minute they fill 11 by 60th part. In 3 minutes they fill 11 by 20th part. So the proportion of R in liquid, so that means in 3 minutes what be the proportion of R? That means 3 by 10. So 1 by 10 into 3, that is 3 by 10. So what is the ratio? 3 by 10 divided by 11 by 10, that gives you 6 by 11 is the ratio. So now let's move to the other question. So this question is quite interesting. Pipes A and B can fill a tank in 20 minutes and 30 minutes respectively, and C can empty it in 15 minutes. If the three are opened and closed one after the other successfully for 1 minute in that order, how soon will the cistern will be filled? That means again there is a tank, there is a tap A, tap B and another tap C. So A, B, C. So A takes 20 minutes. Sorry, here the, I'm extremely sorry. A takes 20 minutes to fill and B takes 30 minutes to fill the tank. Similarly, this tap C drains the tank. So it takes 15 minutes to drain this tank. So this is the outlet and these are inlet. So tap A and B are inlets and tap C is outlet. So tap A takes 20 minutes to fill the tank, tap B takes 30 minutes to fill the tank and tap C takes 15 minutes to fill the tank. So the question asked is, if they are opened and closed successively, that means for 1 minute, first minute, in 1 minute A is opened and the second minute A is closed and B is open, in the third minute C is open. I mean to say, in 1 minute A is open and the second minute B is open, in the third minute C is open, and again in the 4 minute A is open, again fifth B. So this is a cyclic process, is goes on like this. That means these tabs are not opened simultaneously, not opened at a single time. So alternatively, for first minute A is open and second minute B is open. So if this type of question arises, how do you gonna solve this problem? Now let's take A can fill the tank in 20 minutes. So we can solve this question using LCM method. So that would be very easy. So instead of going for the conventional method, so what is that LCM method? A, B, C. So A takes 20 minutes and B takes 30 minutes, C takes 15 minutes. Now what will be the LCM of these three? 60. So we consider it as 60 liters. Now in per minute, so per minute A fills how many liters? That is 3 liters, 60 by 20. So 3 liters per minute here, 2 liters per minute here, 4 liters per minute. So if the LCM is 60, that means A in a minute it fills 3 liters and B fills 2 liters per minute and C drains 4 liters per minute. So these are on alternatively. So first 3 minutes, so first minute A is gonna take 3 liters, fill 3 liters, and B is gonna fill 2 liters in second minute, and C is gonna drain, so minus 4 liters. So in a single, so if you consider it as one part, so if you consider 3 minutes to be one part, in one part just 1 liter of the water will be filled. So to fill 60 liters, how many minutes it would take? So generally you consider this 3 has to be one part. So if you take 60 parts, you are going to get 60 liters, isn't it? So in one part of 3 minutes, that means 1, 2, 3. So first minute, second minute, third minute, in first 3 minutes you are going to get 1 liter. That means 1 liter is filled in the tank. In the next 4th and 5th and 6th minute, you are going to fill again 1 liter. So if this goes on continued, so 60 liters can be filled in how many parts? So if you people may get confused that in one, that means in one part you are going to get 1 liter. So in 60 parts we are going to 60 liter. But that absolutely wrong. So why? Because when you go for the 55th part, so when you reach it for the 55th part, that means 55 into 3. So 3 minutes. So 165 minutes. How much amount of the water will be filled? 55 liters of the water will be filled. So at how much? 55th part. That means 55 into 3. One part is equal to 3 minutes. So at the 55th part, 50 liters of the water will be filled and that is equal to 65 minutes. Now in 56th part, when you are going for the 56th part initially, that means after 165th minute there comes 167th minute, sorry, 166 and 167th minute. So the next chance of 166th minute is A's chance. Here A fills 3 liters. After that B ons, so B fills 2 liters. So completely 60 liters. So there is no chance of going for another 168th minute. So already the water has been filled at 168 minute. So there is no reason to go for the 168 minute. So people generally get confused that, so in one part, that is 3 minutes, in one part which is equal to 3 minutes, if 1 liter of the water is filled, so in 60th part, that means 60th part, so entire 60 liter will be filled. So that is gonna mistake. So please do cross check. So 55 part, that is 165th minute, 55 liters, and 166th minute A has gone on and it fills 3 liters, and 167th minute B is gone on and it takes 2 liters. So after 167, 60 liters will be filled. So our answer is 167 minutes. So it takes 167 minutes to fill the tank. So the final and the last question. A booster pump can be used for filling a well as for emptying a tank. The capacity of the tank is 2400 meter cube. The emptying capacity of the tank is 10 meter cube per minute higher than its filling capacity. And the pump needs 8 minutes lesser to empty the tank than it needed to fill it. So what is the filling capacity of the pump? So the question is very simple. There is a tank. The capacity of the tank is 2400 meter cube. So there is a pump which can be used to fill a tank and it can be used to, let's take this is a pump, so it can fill the tank, and this is the same pump, so we take two pumps, it can fill and it can empty. So he given the tank, the emptying capacity is 10 times more than the filling capacity. That means the filling capacity of the tank of the pump B x meter cube. Now emptying capacity of the pump would be x plus 10 meter cube. So here the question is, so x cube, that means that x meter cube will be filled, is the filling capacity. So in 1 minute, how much amount of the water will be filled? That means how much filling capacity, and it's given. Now how much amount of the time taken to fill this 200, that means 2400 meter cube,
that is equal to
time taken to fill
2400 by x.
Now time taken to drain,
that means time taken to empty
2400 by x plus 10. In the question he has clearly given that the time taken to fill is 8 times greater than, sorry, 8 minutes more than time taken to empty the tank. So 8 minutes. So if you interchange and solve,
so 2400, you take it as common, 1 by x minus 1 by x plus 10, you get 8, 300. So that is equal to x plus 10 minus x by x into x plus, sorry, x into x minus 10 is equal to 1 by 300. You get cancelled, and that is equal to x square minus 10x minus 3000 is equal to 0. So if you solve this, x is equal to minus 50 plus 60, that is equal to x is equal to 50 is our answer. So the filling capacity of the pump is x meter cube, that is equal to 50 meter cube. So there is a tank which is of capacity 200 meter cube, the filling capacity of the pump be x meter cube. So the time taken to the fill is total volume by the capacity. And similarly, the emptying capacity is 10 times more than the filling capacity. So time taken to the empty the tank is total volume of the tank by emptying capacity, that is x plus 10. He has given that this filling capacity is 8 minutes more than the emptying capacity. That means if you subtract filling capacity, time taken by the filling capacity, time taken to fill the tank minus time taken to empty the tank is equal to 8 minutes. So if you solve, you get equation x is equal to 50 meter cube. So that's our answer. So I hope you found all the doubts clarified. So thank you very much to all.